Okay, we're back, and this time we're looking at something called bevelling. So, what's bevelling? Bevelling is about it's the creation of different planes using sloping edges, or the illusion of sloping edges on the face of your object. What do I mean by that? Okay, well, we can do a sort of complete bevel, or we can do a partial bevel. That's my terminology, not general terminology. Let's just get into it so you can see what I'm talking about. Now for this, excuse me, you will need more colours than we've been using before. You're going to need probably about 4 different colours for this one. And you're going to see why. So let's kick off with this one, first of all. So you've got a nice flat square tee. I've just used a very standardized sort of sans serif font there of a tee. It's just a very easy one to illustrate on. So if we do like a full bevel, goes a bit like this. There we go. Little triangles on the end there. how does this go? Now you can do this in different ways. You can do this in, you can either do it like this. Some people like to do it like this, which means that you've essentially got two bars, two separate bars there, or you can do it like that. So it joins. Now that's a more joined up version. So let's run with that one actually, because it's a slightly cleaner aesthetic version. And that's a full beveling. So these are just sloped sides now. They're just sloped. They're only sloped. So if we want to ink them in, I'm gonna colour it without doing an outline on it, for reasons that hopefully will become apparent. So this is, I take my lightest colour, let's work in pinks. Take my lightest colour and we've ascertained the light source. Let's say for simplicity's sake, the light source is coming from directly above, pretty much there. Which means that anything on top there is going to be your lightest colour. Conversely, that means that anything on the bottom, this plane, will be your darkest colour, right? Because it's the farthest away from the light. However, before we get there, we've got to deal with these planes. So next up, we've got this one. I've got a 4-5-4 there, which I'm going to drop in. Where am I going to drop that one in? Let's drop that one in. Let's drop it in. Is that going to work? Yes. Let's drop that in there. So, as you can see, that one's got a bit of a darker hue to it. Same plane, you see that those planes are facing the same direction. Okay, so far so good. Now we want to take a darker one and we want to drop that in on the left hand side. Left hand side, By the way, I'm deliberately doing this with no outline to show you that, and bear in mind that I'm doing it very quick and a bit messy. If you use very sharp lines and pinpoint accuracy, then you can do this stuff with no outline. And this is eventually what, you know, some of you will remember this, some of you won't, and some of you, most of you should know his name. Dime, back in the early 90s, Dime and Neck and Delta, they started to work in this way. They started to work doing graph without outline. Okay, this might not work. I'm going to use a fat purple for this one because I want a really dark one for this one. Really, really dark. Oh, yeah, I think it might work, actually. So Dime and Neck and Delta, and you know, they really started to push the boundaries of no outline graph, and very successfully, I might say as well. Anybody who saw it from back then was blown away by it. It was amazing. Suddenly, it turned the graph world upside down. It really split the graph world at the time. Endlessly, when writers were being interviewed. One of the first things to get asked is, what do you think of Dime? What do you think of the new Dime style? All that, because it was all about, what do you think of no outline graph? You know, because suddenly graph was not being outlined. It was being done like this. Not, I don't mean just all beveled, but I mean, suddenly it was about colour values, because that's what this is, colour values, delineating planes. I know this makes me sound very intelligent, but there we have it. There you go. That's nice, isn't it? I mean, that is so simple to achieve. And I've done it rough as you like as well, as you can tell. And I've done it with them three colours there. So that's what that is. That's all that is. It's them three colours. And as you can see, it's very effective. It's really, really effective. So that kicks us off with that. If I was to, look, by the way, there's no reason you can't then drop an outline on it. I'll just chuck a black outline on this just so you can see. Now, if I was doing a letter this chunky, I would not leave the outline like this. I would at least double it up. I would probably triple it up as well. There we go, just a very rough outline on that. Like I say, I'd probably double that up. I won't do it now because I'm not gunning for perfection right now. Now that looks quite effective as it is, right? That looks quite effective as it is, but we can make it better, even better than that, if we want to. We can start to, for instance, we can start to drop a bit of shading in there. So let's grab our highlighter pen for a second. Let's just pick out this ridge. Just pick out that ridge just there. Because it's edges that catch the light like that. You see that? And we know the light's coming down from there, so it's going to catch that edge. Might catch a bit of that edge as well, maybe. Bit of there as well. There we go. Maybe even just a tiny bit of that one. Bit of this one, maybe. Not all the way down. Maybe to about there. You can play around with this, just you know, I know I've said it before, I'll say it again, don't over-egg it, because it's easier to under-egg something, because if it looks under-egged, you can come back and do a bit more. Whereas if you over-egg it, you can really make a mess and cause yourself a lot of problems. So you seeing this? This is what you can do. I'm just playing with this, really, just seeing where I can go with it. There we go. Yeah, nice. So I'll chuck a bit of highlight on there. and then grab me trusty pencils and I'm gonna do this really quick. So I look at the darkest bits. These are the darkest bits, right? We talked about this, and the darkest bits maybe just need a bit of darkening. Doesn't need very much. Yeah, do as much as you like, really. I don't know if this is coming across on camera, but I've not got my best glasses on, so I can't work out if it's coming out very well or not. So, you seeing this? Basically, this is a very rushed job, but you can see what I'm getting at, right? What I'm doing is I'm adding extra shadow to this dark stuff down here. And it's just, it's given a much nicer variation of value and a graded variation of value in that colour. Now you can do that in colour, by the way. You can do it. If I took that purple and I got a bunch of different purples that all graded with that colour in different values, I could sort of layer it and do all that. But what I've found, it's a bit of a shortcut really, is you do the one colour, then take a pencil to it, and you get this gorgeous effect as well, which is not dissimilar to spray paint. I've had people say to me before, oh, did you use airbrush on that? And I said, no, it's not an airbrush. It's just like a marker with a pencil over the top. That's all it is. Very effective, right? Nice. And ridiculously, absurdly easy. So there we go. Now, like I say, I wasn't going to do this, but I'm going to do it just because I need to show you. So I like fat black graphic lines. That's what I like. These are done very quickly, so they're going to be a bit ropey, but you're going to see what I mean anyway. For me, it needs a fatter outline. And there it is. Needs to be about that thick. No thinner than that. You see, you're getting that. Much more graphic, much more effective. Big and long, hang on. Okay, it's a ropey line. Yeah, I get it. But I'm just using it to illustrate a point. There you go. Big fat black graphic line on that. You can see how quick I've done that. It's just a nice effective way, and you can play with this as much as you like. If you think, oh, actually, do you know what, I'd quite like to do a bit more on that, quite like to put a bit more shine on that, get that nice and shiny just down there, maybe there's a lot more light hitting that just there, you can play a bit more with that and do all that. That's a mess, but you can see where I'm going with that. Likewise, any of those planes, you can just sort of play about with them, do all that. I've seen people do some really lovely kind of like crosshatch. Hang on, if I can find one. If you take a nice little, so these are a point, what they call them, 0.88s, these ones. Oh, this is a purple one. Do a bit of crosshatch on that. You can get some really beautiful effects for your black book. Very nice, right? Stick a couple of bubs in there. Ping, ping, ping. There you go. Just all kinds of stuff. Play about with it. Have some fun with it. It's your book. You do whatever you like with it. So that's like a full bevel, that one. Really full bevel. So what do I mean by a partial bevel? Let's have a look at this one. This one next. What do I mean by this? Well, this is what I mean by this. This one, we go like this. So we're going to create a flat plane on the very top of the thing, if you see what I mean. So this is the flat plane. The top, the very front of the object. The front of the object, this T-shape, is a flat face-on plane. That doesn't have a face-on plane. As you can see, they're all sloped sides. These are sloped sides around the side of this. So again, what I'll do, I'll do the same thing again. Except for this one, I'm also gonna, oh, hang on. Okay, I'm gonna have to do this one slightly differently, aren't I? So, but I'll tell you why I'm gonna have to do this. Sorry, I'm not explaining myself. This is because I do things in my head and forget that I'm not saying them out loud. So these are the colors I've used before, right? These four for this one. I've got an extra plane on this one. Can you see that? Because I've got a face on plane as well. And that has to be the lightest one. Unless what I do is I do the top one as white, which I probably would actually. I do the top one as just a white plane. That's probably the best thing to do. In fact, that is what I'll do. That's exactly what I'll do. So let's make sure that's the lightest one. Otherwise, I really will be in trouble. Moving on. And we'll fill. God, if I use the fat end, otherwise we'll be here all day. I know your time is valuable. Because you need to get in the book and get busy. Come on, man. Work with the thick side. Where are you going? This can't be running out already. These were only bought very recently. Just prior to Christmas by Era One, who very kindly bought them for me. Okay, next up. What we got for this one? Yes, it's this one. And it's this one. I'm using the same principles as I used for this one, by the way. Same colour values on the same planes. You know, and it is undeniably simple to do this. You know, it's not a complex technique. And it is very, very effective. You can do this the minute you get off this video. You can have a go at this. Provided, this is the only thing about it, you do need a decent set of pens, because generally in my experience, I always keep cheap pens around, by the way. It's always worth having them around for numerous different reasons. The only problem with the cheap pens is often they don't grade, their colour values are not specific enough. You don't get a decent enough variation in the colour values. And the cap colour is absolutely no indicator of what you're going to get most of the time. So so it can be a bit ineffective when it comes to doing something like this. Bootleg Sharpies, that's what they are. And they're very, very good for certain bits of work. So there we go. Now, I've left this one white at the top. And it's not as effective as it might be without an outline on it. So let's get it in. Go. So you're seeing this. I'm looking at that thing. That is a little bit white. It's a little bit too white. But I don't have a. That is the most pastel-y pink I've got. I ain't got a lighter pink anyway, I don't think. Or have I? What's that? Hang on. What's that? No, that's a beige. That's no good. I'm sure I've got a lighter pink somewhere. I've used one before, but I don't know where it is. Oh, maybe that's it there. Is that it there? No, that's peach. No. No, scrap that. Okay. Doesn't matter. You get the idea anyway. So you get this. And with this, you could do all sorts of stuff with this. I tell you who uses this a lot, this partial beveling. Look at arrow. I'm going to just quickly sort of put an arrow piece up so you can see. I'll link him in the description so you can go follow him on Instagram. He uses this sort of partial beveling really, really effectively. Really effectively. Somebody who uses this very effectively is a guy called Mr. Basics. Basics in, where is he from? Australia, I think he is. A lot of writers use this, though. A lot of writers use beveling generally. If I can think of any more, I'll link in so you can have a look. You can have a look at them in the wild, you know, what they do. Because like I say, you can do, this is the most basic version I've done here. And you can do as much or as little as you want, really. You know, so I'm putting black line in there. You can do, so this is a way people do it sometimes, is you can put lines in like that, and then you can do a bit of a sort of, a bit of a crosshatch down like that, which fades out. I've used that before. That's very effective. You see that? That's a nice effect. Do the same with the white. Do the same as I've done up here with a pencil. Black some of that in. Change the value and grade it so it looks like it's a bit sort of bit fadey, like you've used spray paint on it. Use you could use a purple. Hang on, I've got a purple somewhere. Where is it? Here it is. If I use a purple pencil, it's really lovely on pink. Look at this. Very nice, right? Really nice. I'm doing a very speedy hatchet job on this, but you can do a really nice fade down there. Don't be afraid to use the finger. Nature's great smudger, the finger. There you go, use a bit of that. You can see where I'm going with this, right? It's very, very effective. You can use a technique that I've already showed you before, which I'll show you really quickly, where you do a sort of, you can do a sort of chromey effect on it. This is not going to be a very good one because I did it in one colour. But if you were to do it in pinks and stuff, in fact, I could just do it in pinks. That would be a, I'll do a very, very quick one. I'll do a very, very quick one for you. So you can see what you can do with this kind of thing. Yeah, you can see where I'm going with this, right? Super effective, right? I'm going to do this really speedy as well. See, this is a very rushed hatchet job, but you can see what can be done. Do the same up there, just do a bit of highlighting stuff, you know, all that. Anyway, you can see what can be done. You can do all kinds of stuff. Play about with it, play about with it. Remember that for this stuff you need the colors. That's the only thing. You can mix the colors up. Some people do all kinds of stuff with the colors. You can do a different secondary light with the color on a beveling. So, you know, this side could be in theory, it could be yellow or green or blue or something like that, and the rest the same kind of colourway. But look, I'd encourage you to have a go yourself and learn to do your name like this. Learn to do your name with like a full bevel or partial bevel. It's a very effective technique. You'll love it. You'll probably end up overusing it, some writers often do, just because it's so good. Because as you can see, it doesn't take very much to suddenly make stuff look three-dimensional. And what we're constantly trying to do, right, is we're trying to make things pop out the page. And this is very, very effective at that. So it's just another little weapon in your armoury to make things jump out. You know, again, I'm just going to sort of remind you, you can use highlights on this stuff. You can play. I'm really encouraging you to look at Arrow, the way he uses stuff. You know, the way he puts his highlights and stuff on his letters, and it's, you know, it's really, really gorgeous what he does with bevelling. You can make them reflective, give them different texture, loads of different colours, all that sort of stuff. You could have a lot of fun with this one, and it, like I say, it's super effective. Even in straight letters, as you can see, these are not jazzed up letters. They're a sans serif, very plain font, and they still look effective. They still look really nice. So have a go at that, guys, and let me know how you get on.